So what if we wanted to know the probability that a Moroccan woman is taller than, let's just keep everything in centimeters to keep this easy. How about taller than 163 centimeters? Well, the answer to that question is still an area under a curve, but it looks slightly different than the last one. Because for this one, we want to find all the area to the right of 163. And actually, this curve goes on forever. And it's true that obviously a woman can't be 12 feet tall, but when we're answering these questions, we need to recognize that these normal curves go on for a while. And to make our calculations as accurate as possible, we're going to keep this in mind. So, okay, to answer this question, we want to find this area. This number here are 163 centimeters. That's going to become the lower value because we want to tell that computer we're always thinking about left to right. What's the smallest number we want it to start calculating the area at? We want it to start at 163. So when we use the normal CDF function, we said the first two numbers are the area, and the first one is the lower, so 163 is going to be the lower value. And then for this one, we want to think about, heck, where's the upper? Where do we want it to stop? Because this area really needs to be calculated for a very, very long ways. So a question like this, a question that involves something that's more than a value, the upper number that we want to use, just needs to be really big. And you have a little bit of creativity here. You just need to pick a number for the upper that is very large. And so just to be safe, I'm going to use 1,000. I could have used 10,000 or 100,000. You can experiment and try different numbers, but you'll see that as long as you put a really big number in for the upper, then you'll have an answer that is almost identical to an answer that somebody else would get if they used a slightly different, very large number. And then we're using the same distribution. We still are dealing with the height of Moroccan women with a mean of 158.5 centimeters and a standard deviation of 6 centimeters. So when I do this in my calculator, I'm going to just give you the rounded value this time. I'm getting 0.2266, which is 22.66%, which is the area to the right of 163 for this particular normal distribution. That's obviously important, right? It's important that we're working with a distribution with this mean and this standard deviation. Anytime we're asking about the height of Moroccan women, we would always use this mean and this standard deviation. But if we were asking about a different variable, we would have different mean and a different standard deviation. So let's look at the last kind of question we might be asked regarding a normal distribution, which is what's the probability that a randomly chosen Moroccan woman is shorter than, let's use 155 centimeters? And the answer to this question is the area to the left of that number. We're thinking about using normal CDF again because a key word that we've got here that's important is that we're looking for a probability, or we could have been asked to find a proportion. And if we know the variable is normally distributed, then normal CDF is going to be the key to finding proportions or probabilities. They're similar ideas. So we're using the same distribution, so the last two numbers here aren't going to change, but the first two are. And so now, this number, 155, that's where we want it to stop. That's going to be the upper value because we want to tell this thing, hey, start way down here and then keep finding area, keep finding area, and keep finding area until you get to 155. It's kind of hard to shade these things because the line gets very close to the x-axis if you get a few standard deviations away from the mean. So anyway, we want to tell this to stop at 155. And so now we want to know, where should we start? And so because this thing goes way far to the left, if we want the area below some number, we're going to give it a really low starting value. We want to tell it to start at a number that's very far to the left here. So just to be safe, I'm just going to give it a very small number. And so I'm going to use something like negative 1,000. I'm just being a little bit creative and choosing numbers that I know are incredibly small or incredibly large. And negative 1,000 is certainly way smaller than I actually need to use. But by using a number that's very, very, very small, I'm just being cautious. I feel when you're doing math, it's a good idea to err on the side of caution, to always be more precise than less precise. So when I do this in my calculator, I get 0.2798, which is 27.98%. So the area to the left of 155 is 27.98%, which is the same thing as the probability that a randomly chosen Moroccan woman is shorter than 155 centimeters. So to summarize, we've used this normal CDF function to find three different types of answers, three different types of areas under the curve. The first is what I'm going to call the between, where you're given two numbers, and those numbers are what you put into the function for the lower and upper values. And if we wanted to write this in symbols, we're really finding the probability that our variable x is less than the upper value and greater than the lower value. So these symbols right here, just really quickly, when I write them down, I know a lot. I know, what do I want? I want the probability that my random variable x is between two values. Or I could be asking for a greater than probability, where I have some number and I want to find the area to the right of that number. And so in that sort of situation, that number that I'm given is going to be the lower, because that's where I want to start. And what this would look like in symbols is that it's the probability that my variable x is greater than whatever the lower value is. And so for that kind of problem, for the upper, where you want to stop, it just needs to be really big. And then the last kind of problem is the less than problem. That kind of problem is going to have some number, and we want to find the area to the left of that. In that case, that number becomes our upper value, and the lower value, in this case, needs to be really small. And if I wanted to write that in symbols, I'm finding the probability that x is less than the upper value. So I give the symbols just because they make our lives easier. Instead of saying, what's the probability that a randomly chosen Moroccan woman is shorter than 160 centimeters, I can just write the probability that x is less than 160 centimeters. And it also turns out that whether this is strictly less than or equal to for this sort of problem doesn't actually make any difference. Because x here is what we call a continuous random variable, whether or not we include this value here, for instance, this 160 centimeters, it doesn't mathematically change the answer to our problem. It was important to pay attention to whether this was strictly less than or equal to with binomial situations, but with these normal probability calculations, that doesn't matter so much. That was probably more than you ever wanted to know about the normal distribution and how to find probabilities and proportions using the normal CDF function. I find it interesting that you can use only a few numbers to answer questions regarding a very large group of individuals. It's fairly powerful information that we'll use for the rest of this course is, if we have a normal distribution, how can we find any area under that? And that's using the normal CDF function.